all must be fine at your home and adapted yourself for online learning to enhance your knowledge. So with this thought, let us begin our topic for class 8 chemistry, that is atomic structure. See, we all know that big things are made up of small things. For instance, right now you are sitting under a room. I am also inside one room. So this room is made up of small, small bricks. That means in chemistry, atom is that small brick. And this atom is the building block of matter. I think I don't have to discuss what is matter right now, because being an 8th standard student, you know matter is anything that occupies space, has mass and can be perceived by senses. So atom is actually the building block of matter. All the big objects, right from the scrapper to the pinhole, they all are made up of very, very tiny particles. If I am saying this much tiny, I would be wrong. So in order to give you a clear picture that what could be the size of atom, I will ask you to take out your scale. This scale or smaller scale, what you have to do with this scale is, you have to see how much 1 inch is. According to my scale, this much length is 1 inch. Okay, so this much 1 inch length can have, let me write down the figure, 254000000. Why I have written this figure? Because 1 inch of length, okay, 1 inch of length, this is not 1 inch, children, okay. I told you what is 1 inch. I have asked you to take out your scale and see how much 1 inch is. So 1 inch length can occupy 25 crores 40 lakhs atom. Okay. I hope you must have got the idea of the size of atom. That atom is so small that it cannot be seen. Sometimes it cannot be seen with under powerful microscope. It is so small. And many scientific thinkers, they work for this atom. I will take few names like Democritus. Okay, this was a Greek philosopher. Then Maharishi Karnad. He was an Indian philosopher. And many other are there who work for this tiny particle. And then we come to know about this atom. Maharishi Karnad was not calling it atom. He gave another name. He was calling it as Anu and Parmanu. Anu means molecule and Parmanu means atom. So these are very, very tiny particles. And I think you got the idea that 1 inch is this much. Okay, this is not 1 inch. Just to make it clear, this much is 1 inch. This 1 inch length can occupy 25 crores, 40 lakhs atom if we are placing atoms side by side. They are so small. Now, after discussing about these scientific thinkers, let us know something about John Dalton. John Dalton, he proposed atomic theory. Okay, he has given atomic theory. And few salient features are also there for his atomic theory. But before discussing the salient feature, I will tell that all these scientific thinkers, they think that atom is invisible. Can we see them with naked eyes? No. So these are invisible and indivisible. Indivisible means cannot be divided further. Okay. So this was one of the salient features of Dalton's atomic theory. Many features are there, like he said that every element is composed of very tiny particles called atom. Then these atoms are indestructible, these it cannot be destroyed, it cannot be created. These can take part in a chemical reaction and form molecules. Then Dalton's atomic theory is also telling us that atoms of a particular element, they are same, they are alike and differ from the atoms of other element. So this was Dalton's atomic theory. His work didn't stop here. He has also given symbols for atom. Okay, he has also given symbols for atom. Why? Because he only realized the importance of writing chemical formula. So he has invented symbol. John Dalton gave atomic theory. He has invented symbol. Why he has invented symbol? Because he realizes the importance of writing chemical formula. So many compounds are there. And sometimes, why the school is assigning you roll numbers? What is the purpose of assigning you roll number? So that whenever exam will be conducted, you people can be seated according to your roll number. Similar is the purpose for writing symbols of a compound. So many compounds are there, every time it is not possible. Suppose I want to say carbon tetrachloride, instead of that I can say CCl4, carbon dioxide, CO2, formula is so small. So he realizes the importance of writing chemical formula. Everything he did, but for one thing he failed. He was unable to give explanation that why the atoms, they differ in their masses. Means he was not having any explanation regarding atomic masses. And this led to the discovery of subatomic particles of atoms. Okay. Now this subatomic particles, in order to make you understand this, let me give one example. Suppose there is one man. Okay, I am representing it with A. Why? Because I want to name this man as atom. Got it? Now this man atom are having 3 children. One children can be named as E, other one can be named as P, and the third one can be named as N. What is the purpose? Why I am using these letters only? Because actually I want to tell you about this atom is the smallest particle of matter and this atom can be further divided. John Dalton said that it is indivisible, it cannot be divided. But modern researchers came, they have shown that atom can be further divided. So this atom can be divided into electron, proton and neutron. Okay, these are subatomic particles of atom. That means atom can be divided, isn't it? Now, if you will compare these 3 subatomic particles, because scientists, they have studied their nature also. So, these electrons are negatively charged, protons are positively charged, and neutron, from the name itself, it is clear, neutral, means no charge. Neutrons are neutral, or you can say no charge. Okay, we have discussed about their charge, but maybe one thing you must be thinking that who discovered these subatomic particles? If John Dalton has not discovered, because he said that atom cannot be divided, then who must have discovered these particles? So let me tell you the name of scientists also. These electrons, they were discovered by J.J. Thomson when he was conducting experiment using gas discharge. Then he came to know that some negatively charged particles are moving and he named them as electron. Then after the discovery of electron, Goldstein, he worked and discovered protons. That some particles, they are moving in the opposite direction. They carry positive charge. So Goldstein named them proton. After that, James Chadwick is another scientist and he is one of the student of Rutherford. Actually, James Chadwick, he was working with Rutherford and meanwhile he discovered neutrons. When he studied these particles, he came to know that they don't carry any charge. They are neutral. So James Chadwick discovered neutron. Now you must be thinking that all the particles must have been discovered together. So it is not correct, because these neutrons, they were discovered after plum pudding model. Okay, plum pudding, all of you know what is pudding, isn't it? And this plum pudding model, it was forward by J.J. Thomson. Okay, he put forward this plum pudding model before the discovery of neutron. Later neutrons were discovered. So in his model, what you will find? Obviously, you will be finding electrons and protons. Neutrons were not discovered. Then how the neutrons can be a part of this model? So according to plum pudding model, J.J. Thomson said that atom is a sphere. Are you drawn a sphere? It is a sphere of positive charge. Positively charged particles. Atom is a sphere of positively charged particle. In between, negatively charged particles are embedded. So in between positively charged particles, you will find negatively charged particles. That was the plum pudding model given by J.J. Thomson. And after that, neutrons were discovered by J.J. Chadwick. And I told you that he was one of the students of Rutherford. See, here I have drawn 7 positive charge and 5 negative charge. I should make the number equal. I think now it is equal. Why I am making equal number of charges? Because this is what he tried to prove, that atom is having equal number of electrons and protons. According to his model, atom is having equal number of protons and electrons. Now what is the consequence of this? That atom is electrically neutral. Atom is electrically neutral. Neutral means no charge. Whenever the number of charge changes, if the positive charges are more, then the atom will be negatively charged. If negative charges are more, then atom will be positively charged. So that cation and anion will be learning later. But till now, when I am explaining atomic structure, you should know that before the discovery of neutron, plum pudding model was given by J.J. Thomson. Somewhat it is acceptable, but we cannot accept it. Why? Because the way he has distributed electrons and protons, this was not correct. Because according to modern research, Rutherford has conducted one experiment. He has conducted one experiment which is known as Rutherford gold foil experiment. Rutherford's gold foil experiment. Now you people must be wondering that atom was discovered, electron, protons, neutrons were discovered. Now what is left in atom? Why Rutherford has done this gold foil experiment? Actually, inside the atom, there is a small nucleus, okay? A centrally located hard nucleus is present inside the nucleus, and Rutherford, he discovered that only using a gold foil. For that, he took alpha particles, and for getting alpha particles, he brought the radioactive element polonium. From that, alpha particles were scattered. They were allowed to fall on gold foil, they passed through gold foil, and then they strike zinc sulfide screen. So there he has seen that some of the particles, they are moving straight without showing any deviation. Some of the particles, they are deflected to certain angles, and some of the particles, they revert back, means they return back to their path. So after observing this, he has drawn one conclusion, that there is something inside the atom. There is something which is present inside the center of the atom. So Rutherford called it nucleus. Okay. Now nucleus is discovered. But the problem is there something more in nucleus? So he thought that why these particles are returning? These are alpha particles. These are alpha particles, and we know the nature of alpha particles, that these are positively charged. And returning back means here also something is present which is positively charged, that's why they are returning back. Because we know that like charges repel each other and unlike charges attract each other. So this is the reason that this nucleus is positively charged. Now why it is positively charged? So these are positively charged because of the presence of nucleus is positively charged because of the presence of proton. Not only proton is present inside the nucleus, even neutrons are present. And according to chemistry, these protons and neutrons together they are known as nucleons. Okay, there is one term. Together, protons and neutrons can be called as nucleons. So if somebody is asking what is nucleons, you can say that the particles which are present inside the nucleus are called nucleons. Now I think you must have got a rough idea that what is atomic structure, which is our topic, because so many discoveries, electrons, protons, I have told you. Now if somebody asks, somebody is asking you to draw the structure of atom. So a diagrammatic representation of atom can be like this. This is nucleus. I said that inside the nucleus, nucleons are present. P stands for proton. N means neutron. And electron is outside the nucleus. It is orbiting around the nucleus. As you know that in solar system, the planets, they are revolving around the sun. In a similar way, electrons, they are moving around the nucleus. And again, they are moving in a specified path. This path is imaginary. I have drawn in order to make you understand. This is electron, okay, negatively charged particle. It is outside the nucleus. Inside the nucleus, protons and neutrons are present. Got it? The mass of electron is very less, but these are having mass, and the total mass of atom is because of these particles only. So this John Dalton, he failed to explain about the mass. That's why scientists, they were finding the answer, and this is how these subatomic particles of atom, they were discovered. So this is atomic structure, or you can say structure of atom, which is having nucleus. Inside the nucleus, protons, neutrons, and outside the nucleus, electrons are present, which are moving in a specified path. This path is known as shell. Okay, this you can consider as a structure of hydrogen. Why? Because in hydrogen, only one proton and one electron is present. So this structure can be considered as atomic structure of hydrogen. But if you want to draw for other element, like suppose carbon, then you should know what is the atomic number of carbon. It is 6. Now if directly I will draw atomic structure, then you people must be thinking what is atomic number. First we should know what is atomic number, then only we will be able to draw its atomic structure. So in order to explain atomic structure, first I will tell you the concept of atomic number. Okay, first you should know what is atomic number of an element. It is again like a roll number. Okay, we have arranged, scientists have arranged elements in a table, in a chart, which is known as periodic table. And these elements are assigned with a number that is known as atomic number. But this is not the right definition, children. Why? Because this atomic number is due to unit positive charge of an element. Just now I told for hydrogen that the figure can be considered for hydrogen. Why? Because one electron and one proton is present. So atomic number is the number of unit positive charge. Now I don't have to tell that why these positive charges are present, because we know the positive charge is due to the presence of protons inside the nucleus. That means atomic number is the number of proton. And later we have learned that atom is electrically neutral. That means whatever number of protons are present, the same number of electrons are present inside the atom. Outside the nucleus and in the atom. That means atomic number is number of proton, or it can be number of electrons. Why it can be same? Because both are equal, isn't it? For a stable atom. For atom to be electrically neutral, the number of protons should be equal to number of electrons. So this is known as atomic number of an element. Now if I am saying that atomic number of carbon is 6, that means it is having 6 protons and 6 electrons. So this is what atomic number. Now the next concept is mass number. And when I was explaining the structure, I told that electrons has very less mass and the mass of atom is due to protons and neutrons. So obviously mass number is the number of nucleons. I think you remember what is nucleon, what are nucleons? The sum total of protons, because they are inside the nucleus, and sum total of neutrons. One word for protons and neutrons is? Protons and neutrons is nucleons. Remember this term, because mass number is number of nucleons. So when you will add up proton and neutrons, you will get mass number. Alright, atomic number is number of proton, both are same, so you can also call it that atomic number is number of electrons. Mass number is sum total of protons and neutrons. Why? Because protons and neutrons are present inside the nucleus and they only contribute for the mass of atom. That's why we are adding the number of protons and neutrons. Here I have told you that atomic number of carbon is 6. And mass number is 12. If I am saying mass number is 12, what does it mean? If I am saying mass number is 12, then see this formula. It means total number of protons and total number of neutrons. In case of carbon, neutrons and protons are also same. 6. They are same in number. So it is easy for you to calculate. Suppose I am representing this mass number with the letter Z I am representing atomic number with the letter Z and mass number with the letter A. And I am asking you to find out the number of protons, electrons and neutrons. Is it possible? Can we do that? Surely we can do that. How we can do? Suppose you know the mass number. You can subtract atomic number. So what you will get? Number of neutrons. Okay, we got it, number of neutrons. Now how to find out electrons and protons? What we should do? Nothing. Because we know that atomic number is equal to number of protons and number of electrons. So by this simple formula, you can find out the number of all the three subatomic particles. Electrons and protons also you can find out with the help of this formula, because they are same, these are same, isn't it? This is atomic number represented by Z, the number of protons, they are equal to number of electrons and they are known as atomic number. So there is nothing you have to do. If you know atomic number, that means you know the number of electrons, you know the number of protons. The only thing you have to calculate number of neutrons, which you can find out by subtracting atomic number from mass number. So this is how this atomic number and mass number, they are helping us. Now, as I told you that for drawing atomic structure, we should know atomic number, because I want to tell how to draw atomic structure. Here we have considered an example of carbon whose atomic number is 6. So draw one nucleus. You can write down P and N, P for proton, N for neutron. Then you can draw these shells. Okay. Now these shells, they have their own capability of accommodating electron. All the 6 electrons will not come in particular shell. There is one rule which is known as 2N square rule. This rule was given by the scientist Bohr Bury. And it is known as Bohr-Bury scheme. 2N square rule, where N represents number of shell. Now using this formula, can we find out the capacity of a particular shell? Surely we can find out. The capacity of particular shell. Suppose this is your first shell, and in chemistry, name of this shell is K. K is first shell, and after K, which letter is coming? K, L, M, N. This way you can write down the name of the shell. So we want to know the capacity of first shell, that is K. For that, we can use this formula. First shell means the value of N is 1, 2 multiplied by 1 with the square of 1, because I have written N square, will give you the answer 2. That means first shell can accommodate 2 electrons. Okay. First shell can accommodate 2 electrons. Here I am writing shell, so that will be easy for you. Then come on second shell. Again same formula, 2n square. So here n is square of 2. For second shell surely we will be writing 2. Square of 2 will give you 4. 4 multiplied by 2 will give you 8. That means second shell can accommodate 8 electrons. Then you can do it for third and fourth shell also. 3 threes are 9. 9 twos are 18 electrons in third shell. Then 4, 32 electrons in fourth shell. Okay, so this way. Now if you want to draw the structure of carbon, what you have to do? Now we got an idea that first shell can accommodate 2 electrons. So in K shell, we will draw 2 electrons. Second shell, there are 8 electrons. So you can draw. Will you be drawing 8 electrons? No. How we can draw 8 electrons? Atomic number is 6 only. And out of 6, already 2 we have accommodated. So, 2 minus 2, if you are subtracting from 6, 4 are remaining. That means second shell will have 4 electrons. This is how you can draw atomic structure of carbon and other elements also. Got it? With the help of 2, this 2n square rule, where these are shells. The name of shell is K, L, M, N and so on. We can write down the atomic structure of element. Until 20, everybody should know the atomic number of element, so that you don't have to think how to draw the structure. If you are knowing atomic number, if you are knowing this formula, 2n square rule, very easily you can draw the atomic structure. I told you about atomic structure. Then the arrangement of electron in particular shell, that is known as electronic configuration. So children, I hope atomic structure, electronic configuration is clear to you. Before ending up, I would like to say that as atoms are building block of matter, similarly good deeds are building block of human values. Your small good, small efforts can cause greater good in others' life. With this thought, thank you.